All right, hi Pisces. You guys are up next for your love message. This is for Pisces placement, sun, moon, rising, and Venus signs. Take what resonates, leave what doesn't. This is what you guys need to know in regards to love right now. For those of you who are married or, you know, you have kids with someone, I see you guys mending things and making things better or finding a peaceful resolution. Even if you guys, like, for those of you who are married and, like, staying, you know, you guys could be deciding to stay together or you guys, you know, marriage counseling, the kids could be getting counseling, family counseling, whatever. And I feel like there's going to be some, yeah, resolve if there was any problems. And then for those of you who are, like, separated or divorced, you guys are going to be, you know, peaceful resolutions, co-parenting, you know, things like that. And then for some of you guys may be realizing how your childhood and the things you've gone through as a child has really impacted your love life. So you guys may be needing to focus on forgiving your mother or your father or both parents, okay? Whether they were there physically or not. You know, some people, you know, parents can be there physically, but maybe your emotional needs weren't met, you know? So that came up in your last reading about you guys' solar plexus. You guys having a hard time asserting your boundaries or asserting yourself because you guys weren't really given that space to do so as a child. So what do Pisces placements, sun, moon, rising, and Venus need to know and love? Yeah, it says free yourself. It's time to take back control of your life. Okay. You got chemistry. There is a strong magnetic attraction here. Okay. Ooh. We got wedding. Yeah, some of you guys are married or getting married. This situation involves marriage. Some of you guys are going to be making the effort in your marriage for those of you who are married. For those of you who are boyfriend, girlfriend, or just date, you know, I see you guys getting married. Some of you guys have a really strong magnetic attraction to someone, or they do to you. You got true love. For some of you guys, you are with your true love. You met your true love, or you will be soon. This person brings out your playful side. We got, this is a romance of a lifetime. I just washed my hair, y'all. So I got the conditioner sitting in. So after I do you guys' reading, I'm going to wash it out. And then, we got religious factors. Your love life is influenced by your religious upbringing and spiritual path. Let me get one more. Yeah, healing family issues came out again. Your love life benefits as you forgive your parents. So some of you guys have some inner childhood wounds to heal and to face and deal with. That could be why your marriage is a certain way, you know, dating, or, you know, just how you approach love, how you see yourself, what you think you're worth, what you tolerate, what you're afraid to speak up and ask for, passive aggressiveness and, you know, shit like that, toxicity and stuff, you know. The usual, right? We all gone through it. All right, so what's free yourself for Pisces? Some of y'all could be dealing with somebody that's very emotionally manipulative or abusive. You could be dealing with a Cancer, a Libra, or a Scorpio, or another Pisces. You guys can have those signs in your chart somewhere, or the person does. So some of you guys feel stuck in something. Five of Pentacles, Ten of Pentacles here. We got the King of Pentacles, Taurus energy, or any earth sign, Virgo, Capricorn in reverse. Somebody could have been disloyal. Somebody could have been cheating. Libra energy here. Okay, so Five of Pentacles. Some of you got, yeah, some, okay, hold on. This is for yourself. Yeah, Six of Swords in reverse. Some of y'all are stuck. So some of you guys, yeah, I feel like it's lining up with this. You know, some of y'all could have been neglected some way, shape, or how as a child. And you guys have carried on with life with that type of thought process. Like, I feel like it's hard for some of you guys to be, where's my chapstick? My lips feel really chapped. I'm sorry, Pisces. I just don't want to have to keep licking my lips. Hold on, my lips feel so chapped. Whatever, if it really bothers me, it is bothering me. Hold on, Pisces. All right, I feel like some of you guys could have felt abandoned by someone, or someone feels abandoned by you. Okay, I just feel like somebody has a heart. Again, we spoke about peaceful resolution, whether it's marriage counseling, you know, whether it's, you know, family or whatever, or even maybe personal for yourself. But this Five of Pentacles talks about poverty, abandonment, neglect. Okay, this in some cases this could be like home and stuff like that. Somebody may be needing, some of you guys could feel stuck and trapped living with somebody here. Okay, I also feel like somebody here may have some type of abandonment issue, so they may have a hard time leaving you behind, or vice versa. They have a hard time like leaving. Somebody here has a hard time freeing themselves from something or someone. This could be you or the other person. Flip it and switch it. Okay, it's your reading, so I'm here for you. So I'm gonna speak as if I'm talking to you. If it's the other person, just flip it. Certain parts of the story are gonna be you, and certain parts are gonna be other people or the other person, right? What's this for yourself? But let's see. Yeah, somebody, yeah, Seven of Swords. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? This is what I'm saying. Somebody could also be Gemini energy here with the Lovers. Somebody here could, this could be same sex for some of you guys here, right? Because in this Lover's card, in this deck, at least, these are two women, it looks like. It could be male or female, but for some of you guys, it could be same sex. Or somebody could be bisexual or whatever. I feel like somebody could also be coming out with about their sexuality. Okay, you could be finding out that somebody is bisexual or gay, you know, whatever. It doesn't matter. But somebody could have been in the closet about that. So somebody may be coming out the closet with that. Yeah, this may be something that you see on social media or something like, or you may find something on their phone or some shit like that. What's this for yourself? Or you can, yeah, I feel like for some of you guys, if you're having a hard time, so there could have been arguments, there could have been mean things that were said, okay, some type of verbal mental abuse. If you guys are having a hard time finding a peaceful resolution, some of you guys may need, with this Three of Pentacles, some of you guys may need to go seek professional assistance, especially for those of you who are married or in a relationship. You know, some of you guys may need to do that. For others of you who are single, or you're just in a relationship, you're not married or whatever, you're just dating, you guys may need to speak to a professional. You know, some of you guys could have experienced something in the past, your childhood, or before this person, or before you got married, or you know, you, something that's interfering with your dating life. You guys may be having a hard time moving on from this or getting past this on your own. And we're not meant to heal everything on our own all the time. Some things we can do on our own, some things we do need assistance of others. It's okay to reach out and ask for help. It's okay, you know what I'm saying? Like, there's nothing wrong with getting assistance and getting help. A lot of you guys with this free yourself, y'all are having a hard time doing that. Okay, and some of you guys just need to be honest with yourself, right? What's, you know, for some of you guys, this person, this relationship, this marriage, it reminds you, it remodels the one that you saw with your parents growing up, or the lack thereof that you have, or you're holding so tightly onto this person because you didn't have nobody, or you felt neglected by your parents or your parent, you know, whichever it is, or whatever, you know, whoever made you feel left out in the cold. So a lot of, you know, there's a lot that there's a lot of, you know, it's like you guys are carrying around baggage and new relationships. So this is either you or the person you're dealing with. But yeah, some of you guys are carrying that. Yeah, some of y'all are carrying around old shit. And for others of you, I feel like somebody here is like, so those of you who are like in a marriage, I'm getting there's somebody, and that's, I mean, I don't want to jump to conclusions. What's the Three of Pentacles? King of Pentacles reverse. So this is King of Pentacles in reverse. Ace of Swords here. So somebody may come out about a third party here, or about something, an affair. Somebody could have had an affair at work. Okay. Somebody could be coming clean about that. And I feel like, you know what I'm saying here with the Seven of Swords, the Seven of Swords minus the Six in reverse is the Ace upright. So in order for you guys, so okay, boom, this is the story. In order for something, in order for you guys, you and this person, your, you know, husband, wife, boyfriend, girlfriend, in order for something to move forward peacefully and honestly with integrity, somebody needs to be honest about some. Seven of Swords is deception, secrets, lies, deceit, conning, trying to get away with something. You know, somebody could be deceiving themselves because of their type, their past wounds and shit like that they haven't dealt with. But somebody needs to be honest with themselves. King of Pentacles, business owner, okay? Some, again, the Three of Pentacles, somebody could have had an affair with somebody at their job. Somebody could have said somebody was just a friend and they weren't. And somebody needs to come clean about that. The King of Pentacles in reverse is somebody that pays for sex, okay? You know, they pay for prostitutes. You know, they exchange sexual favors for money or rice, you know, and shit like that. They're disloyal. They're greedy. So, you know, selfish. So somebody here needs to be honest. Somebody here needs to come clean about something in order for there to be forward movement and for things to change. Somebody's not being honest. And somebody needs to do that. Somebody could be coming clean about this already. What's this? And maybe somebody, maybe you guys, you found out about this and you guys can't, you know, you guys are, with the Six of Swords here, you guys may be having a hard time moving forward. You could have told this person, like, yeah, I forgive you. It's okay. We'll move forward. We'll work on it. And you guys kind of either bring it up during arguments. You could be acting passive aggressive. You know what I'm saying? Shit like that. Somebody could be finding out that somebody, or I don't know. What's the Six of Swords here? It's a lot. Yeah, Nine of Pentacles. Somebody here was acting single. I also feel like somebody here misses being single. Somebody here misses being single. Somebody has a hard time. Also, somebody has, whoever this Nine of Pentacles energy is, this can be somebody else. This is either somebody misses their freedom. Somebody here could feel mentally, somebody here needs more freedom in their marriage. And somebody here needs to be honest about that. Maybe an open marriage, polygamy, maybe something that may work better for somebody here. You know what I'm saying? Somebody here could also have been engaging in threesomes and shit like that. But what's this Nine of Pentacles, child? Yeah, Five of Wands. Yeah, so I feel like the conflict is somebody here is like they like this marriage, this relationship, but also somebody here is struggling with their freedom. Somebody here really likes their freedom more than anything. Okay, Aquarius, Capricorn here, or any air sign, heavy air. Taurus is here as well. Libra, Cancer, you know, Pisces, Scorpio and shit. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, and you know all signs are here, but I don't see no cups yet. So you know, I feel like also somebody here.
There could have been fights over. There could also be fights over money in this situation. Somebody hasn't. What's this Five of Wands? It's like somebody needs to be honest. Yeah, Four of Cups. Seven of Cups. I feel like somebody daydreams and fantasizes about other stuff, whether they're married, committed, or whatever. Somebody here is not really living in their truth here. Somebody could be a Libra, have Libra placements, or be dealing with one. Somebody's not living in their truth. Somebody's feeling apathetic, emotionally withdrawn here. Somebody's afraid of fully committing because they don't want to miss out. You could definitely be dealing with a Libra or somebody with Libra placements. Well, you may have, I don't know. But you know, somebody here fears making the wrong choice. Somebody here fears settling down because they're like, oh, okay, what if I settle down with Pisces, or this is you, then what if I miss out on these options, or what if I miss out on this, or what if I miss out on that? Somebody here is like, you know, somebody here looks good, they make good money, they somebody here is very self-sufficient, they can have their own business, or they just do well financially. They know how to take care of themselves. So that may be why it's hard for them to settle down. They know they're very self-sufficient. So people who are very self-sufficient are hardest to pin down because they're not coming from a place of codependency. So they're not going to be in a rush to commit. You know, they don't really need, I'm not going to say they don't need nobody, because we all need, you know, we're not meant to be alone. But you get what I'm saying? Like, this person isn't that, for some people, it's like a do or die for them to be with somebody. For this person, it's not. They look good. Their money is good. They like to feel free. They don't like to feel bogged down. This person may even have an avoidant attachment style. You may have a more of an anxious attachment style, anxious, clingy one, and they may have a more avoidant and distant one here. There could be differences in attachment styles for sure. One person likes to cling, the other person just wants their freedom and shit like that. What's this Five of Pentacles? There could also be things, King of Swords here. Somebody could have grown up in a group home, a foster care, something like that. Somebody could have also had parents that were really stern, especially if they were air sign parents, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, or this is you, or this is someone you're dealing with. But somebody here is just very stern, cold. You know, somebody's not very emotionally giving. I don't see no cups out here yet. What's this King of Swords? Yeah, Nine of Wands. Yeah, somebody's strong here. Somebody could have really long hair, locks. You guys may like sunflowers here. You guys are very wise. I feel like you guys know your triggers. You guys know, like, your insecurities. And that could be why you guys are just with this Nine of Pentacles. For some of you guys who are single and just dating or taking things slow, you guys can be very much like, okay, I know what my insecurities are. I'm very aware, I'm clear on that. So I just want to sit and focus on that right now. Some of you guys want to focus on your looks. You guys want to focus on just healing. You know, I don't think some of you guys aren't really too worried about missing out on opportunities because you guys are focusing on yourselves here. You guys want to focus on yourselves. That's what spirit is calling you to do. That's what something is calling you to do. And that's what you should do. That's what you should do. I also feel like somebody here could be cold and a bit detached and removed because that's their defense mechanism. This could be you or someone you're dealing with, but somebody has to get out of that survival mode. So ego and survival mode it can't really exist in love. It doesn't exist well in love. I'll put it that way. It doesn't. Somebody here is very strong, but it's from a place. Somebody, you know, just like, you know, when we can be very, somebody here is very self-protective, and that keeps bad things out, but it also keeps good and beautiful things from coming in. So, you know, there's two sides to every coin, right? What's the Seven of Swords here? But I feel like a lot of you guys, your experience, your wisdom, it makes you guys extremely beautiful. That's what this person, or that's what people find very beautiful about you. Some of you guys could have had an absent mother, whether she was physically absent or emotionally absent. So she could have raised you, but maybe she has so much other stuff going on, other kids and other things like that. So, you know, and then for others of you, you guys grew up in a group home or a foster care. Somebody was adopted. What's this Seven of Swords here? You got two kings here too. So... yeah, Page of Swords here. Yeah, I feel like before you go forward with something or someone, Pisces, get as much facts about this person, because with this Seven of Swords and this Page of Swords here, somebody here, you know, you guys could be getting to know somebody. You guys could be like getting a car, you know, checking the Carfax on someone, getting the details, the deets, especially if you work with this person here or you met them through work or through a friend or something like that. Okay. You guys are needing to get details with somebody before just moving forward. What's the Seven of Swords? Because somebody's not really honest. either they're not honest about what they've been through, and it's hard to be, and it's hard to date somebody where you don't really know them well, because if a foundation starts off like that, and this Seven of Swords energy lies in deceit, then that's when, sorry guys, that's when later on, that's it being built on a false foundation, and that's when, I won't be surprised if the Tower comes out. That's when the Tower comes and destroys anything that has been built on a falsely foundation, so it can be rebuilt with integrity, with honesty, transparency. Okay, so somebody here needs to be transparent in order for them to be able to move forward. In order for this person to move forward, in order for you guys to move forward, in order for you to move forward and for you to have a better dating experience, better relationship experiences or whatever, somebody here needs to either be transparent and honest about their healing journey and what they've gone through and or how they feel and how they've been hurt, whether it's by past lovers, parents or whatever, siblings, whoever, you know, or if this is something, if you guys are married and committed and somebody stepped out and did something, somebody needs to be honest about that. Somebody also may suffer from rejection wounds, so they just, you know, somebody holds really tightly onto their freedom, and there's somebody could also be a bit stingy with themselves. What's the Seven of Swords? Page of Swords again. So yeah, you guys need to get the facts on somebody. Take your time with this person. A lot of swords here. Yeah. I don't see no cups. This Ace of Cups is in reverse. And we got the Queen of Swords here. But, you know, so some of you guys could be married to this person. Maybe there's not much love there. Or you guys could just be pouring from empty cups. So that could be, it could be very, the day-to-day stuff can be really, like, tedious and boring and stale. Both of you guys could be pouring from an empty cup. So some of you guys may need to, even if you guys live together and marry, you guys may need to take some space from each other. Do something to pour into yourselves and hold each other accountable with that. Babe, did you go to the gym today like you said you were? Or babe, did you go to the spa? Did you go get your nails done? Did you go get your massage? Did you go, you know, go for your evening walk to decompress? Did you go have a good time with the girls or the guys? You know, there could be some of that for those of you who are married or in relationships. You guys may need some more independence from each other, especially if you have other responsibilities and stuff like that. But others of you, somebody here is finding, yeah, somebody knows. I feel like you guys know somebody's lying. I also feel like some of you guys could be thinking that somebody is still lying to you or still keeping secrets or still being deceptive. And they could be. Let's see. What's this Page of Swords? This is the first 22 minutes in, and it's only the first card, child. This is Page of Swords. Let's keep this cute. Ten of Cups, yeah, in reverse. Yeah, Four of Pentacles in reverse. So I feel like somebody here, yeah. So is this Ten of Cups here? Somebody could be fine. This could be domestic violence here. Okay, an unhappy home, a broken home. Right, you guys could be learning that this person could have saw their parents in domestic violence. Somebody could also be in a woman's shelter, a man, you know, male. They need more of those for men. I don't know if they have them for men, but somebody here could be looking up, you know, places, you know, ways to escape something. This could be somebody here could be in domestic violence, and somebody here could be finding ways to escape this or get out of this. Yeah, somebody could be plotting on how to get away from somebody that's financially abusive, verbally, mentally, emotionally, physically even, maybe. Somebody also withholds affection when they don't get their way. Somebody here is very passive-aggressive and aggressive at the same time. There's an unhappy home here, though. And I feel like somebody's been eyeing that, and they've kind of, like, that's how they could have, like, made their move or something. Asking questions like, oh, how's your wife? How's your husband? How's the kids? And based on this person's body language and how they responded, somebody kind of knew how to, like, you know, slip into the crevices. You know, somebody let their guard down. What's this Ten of Cups in reverse? Yeah, Seven of Pentacles. Okay, so pages are the kids. That's the Page of Swords. So somebody could have. So there could be an outside baby that happens. that somebody could be trying to keep, somebody that's something that's been hidden. I feel like you guys can either sense this. We'll see what comes out in the reading. You guys may sense this or know this. Or some of you guys could be hiding your pregnancy from your family or from people in general. Seven of Pentacles, and you know, and for some of you guys, you could have been with this person for seven to 10 years, okay? I feel like some of you guys have invested a lot of time, energy, money into this relationship. She said it's your child, and it really messed me up. How could you deny your own flesh and What's that Mary J. Blige song? Hold on, y'all. Y'all know I gotta get my map. I gotta get the laptop out. Gotta face reality. There can never be anymore. Somebody could have had an outside baby. Hold on, but real quick. I'm gonna play it real quick. You guys can hear it still. Somebody could be pregnant. Somebody could.
It's too bad,
baby. But I gotta face reality. Oh, what's this Ace of Swords?
It's too bad.
The Empress.
Too bad.
Three of Swords. The Star card. Something can be healed, but you could be dealing with an Aquarius, a Taurus, or Libra.
Today you had a visitor, or should I say an old friend? Oh, wait a minute. That's not where it is, no. Is there something that you wanna tell me?
So you got the Ten of Cups here in reverse, but the Nine of Pentacles upright.
Girlfriend, she wasn't disrespectful. In fact, she's 100% sure. And how can I argue with her? Holding on, baby, with my mind. She said it's your child. And it really messed me up. Face reality,
there can never be any
more
of us. Somebody pregnant.
Yes,
somebody made. All right, you know, I don't like to be the bearer of bad news. I really don't, y'all. But somebody here could be pregnant. Somebody here could be a single parent. Somebody may be pregnant, and, you know, unfortunately they're somebody may end up being a single parent here. Because somebody could have lied about being married or lied about something, and you know, that's not really your fault or the other woman's fault or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Wheel of Fortune here, yeah. There's gonna be a new beginning and there's gonna be a shift here, there's gonna be a change. And something, this was destined, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, it's hard, sometimes it's hard for us to understand things that happen on the 3D, but this is why it's important for us to have a balance of our spiritual, our higher and lower selves, the 3D and the 5D, because there are certain things that happen in ways we don't like that are meant to happen. And the ways they happen, sometimes they suck here. But something is changing here. If this is not a pregnancy, this could just be something is growing here. Somebody could be getting their boobs done too. Or somebody has nice titties, but really nice boobs. Somebody could be a boob man or a boob woman, whatever. Same sex, you could be a boob woman. But yeah. Yeah, because they could have been a pregnancy outside of a relationship, a connection, a marriage. Or, yeah, somebody's finding this out, too, that somebody's pregnant. What's the Seven of Pentacles? Child, I didn't want this to be a long reading. It's already 30 minutes. What's the Seven of Pentacles? I'm going to keep everything else short. Yeah, the Page of Pentacles. Somebody could be having an earth sign baby, or what's this? Or girl? I don't know.
Yeah, Seven of Cups.
I feel like somebody doesn't want to face reality here because they've invested in something so long, you know, but yeah, Seven of Cups. So three sevens. This is a warning. So if this hasn't happened yet, if somebody is stepping outside of their relationship, their marriage, they need to stop. Because either an outside child is going to get born, or somebody's going to get pregnant by somebody that is not their spouse or their significant other. So, yes. Somebody could also be fantasizing about getting you pregnant, Pisces. Be careful with that. Something is destined, though. What's this? Something with the Wheel of Fortune. Something is destined to happen here, but there needs to be some forward movement from the past. Somebody, you know, there needs to be honesty, so there could be forward movement here. What's this chemistry here? The Lovers, Gemini energy. Yeah, some of y'all have a strong connect. Ten of Swords. Yeah, or if this is not you guys, maybe this person has this strong connection with your significant other or whatever. I also feel like some of you guys, this could be a twin flame dynamic if you guys subscribe to that. If not, it's fine. But I feel like some of you guys here, if you're not having this healing and this intense sex, you are going to be. You know, the Lovers is good sex, which can result in a pregnancy. So be careful, that's not what you want. Okay? Yeah. You could be dealing with a Gemini here. What's this chemistry? The Queen of Pentacles in reverse. Now we got the King and Queen of Pentacles in reverse. Yeah, somebody. So this may be an open marriage or a relationship where both people just kind of like do them and then come back home to each other type thing. Six of Cups, you may have kids with this person here, or yeah, Six of Cups, Six of Wands, Six of Swords. You guys may have kids with them, or you know, you grew up with this person, you could have known them for a long time. This could be a past life soulmate as well. That could be why the connection is so strong, whether somebody is married or single or not. Somebody has a strong past life connection and magnetic pull to someone that may not be their significant other or spouse or whatever. Sagittarius, Capricorn energy here with this Queen of Pentacles or any earth sign. What's this chemistry here? Ten of Pentacles in reverse. So, and we got the Hangman, your energy here in reverse. So, yeah, this could be an open marriage. Some of you guys could be realizing that, I don't know, somebody here could be needing to be honest about somebody here could be wanting to try an open marriage. Open relationship, that may actually work. Or there could be a separation or a divorce because of lots of infidelity. What's this chemistry here? Yeah, Nine of Cups. Yeah. Somebody's wife or a significant other could be going on dates with other people, okay? It's like somebody is not really focusing on their family, their commitments right now. Somebody could even be like saying, oh, I'm staying late at work, or I gotta travel for work, or I gotta do this thing for work. And they just have this pull to somebody that they just, yeah, man. What's the Lovers here? Five of Swords here, yeah. Somebody may also feel defeated here. Somebody could also be confused about who to choose here, okay? Yeah, Four of Wands, marriage, twin flames. This could be, yeah, soulmate, celebration, family coming together. Somebody's family could be like, you know, like, oh, how could you do this? And somebody's family members could be getting involved, or they don't want to disappoint the family. Maybe this person comes from a nice family that has welcomed them in and stuff like that. Somebody could be a leader in their community, so they don't want to be looked at a certain way. What's this Five of Swords here? the Empress, Taurus, Libra energy. Somebody's pregnant. Somebody, yeah. Some of y'all about to be pregnant. Some of y'all are gonna, some, like, it's like the sex is so fucking good that y'all just gonna, I mean, yeah, somebody here is pregnant or is going to be pregnant. Either is pregnant, finding out about a pregnancy, whether it's somebody in the family, whether it's somebody outside the relationship or marriage or whatever, or there's pregnancy here. This could also be somebody's baby mother or the mother of their kids, or I don't know, but this is, somebody could still be sleeping with their child's mother or father. I don't, this is, what's this Ten of Pentacles anyways? I feel like somebody could also be getting kicked out of a home. Yeah, the Emperor in reverse. Some Aries energy. Some of you guys, this is a twin flame situation. You may not know what that is, so you may want to look it up. Yeah, Two of Wands. Somebody's planning on leaving a family. The moon card here, Cancer energy, Pisces, and we got the Strength card, Leo. Somebody could have lied about being married here, but I feel like it's because they had this magnetic pull to you or vice versa, and they didn't want to lose that. That could have been why they could have been like friend zoning or just keeping things, you know, in and out, hot and cold. You may not have known where you stood with this person. They could have lied about either a relationship, a long-term one, or being married. But they have this very insane chemistry. They're insanely drawn to you. Their back is turned to this Ten of Pentacles. Both the Two of Wands and this Knight of Cups is turned to it. What's this Two of Wands here? Aries and Scorpio energy with that Mars card. What's this here? Or Virgo, Gemini. What's this Two of Wands? Yeah, I feel like somebody's planning something. So we got the Sun card, Leo energy, Four of Swords here. Yeah, somebody is restless. They're not getting sleep here. Somebody's having a heart. Somebody's exhausted here. Somebody's also exhausted wearing this mask and acting like everything's okay when they're not really pretending to be happy when they're really not. Yeah, this could also, yeah, somebody is planning on how to go towards this. Yeah, somebody can't stop thinking about somebody too. Some of you guys may also, somebody here may also suffer from depression, or some of you guys need to go out and get some more sun. You guys need to go get some more sun. You could be having a hormone imbalance. You guys need to go out and get some more sun here. What's this? King of Pentacles in reverse. All these cards falling on the floor. Ten of Swords. I'm telling you, somebody's wife, husband, wife, somebody here, somebody's partner is this. Yeah, this is going to crush somebody. This Ten of Swords here. Something, you know, the worst part of something is over. I always say that when I see that, but something is ruined. Like something is, somebody could have done this over and over and over. Five of Cups. Somebody could be, you know, suffering from heart issues because their heart is broken. Literally. What's this Ten of Swords? Yeah, Six of Cups in reverse. I also feel like if somebody keeps bringing up things from the past, somebody can't get over the past here. Yeah, somebody's finances, somebody's gonna have to get back on their feet slowly here because of this marriage, because of this separation, this a loss of a home or divorce or something like that. Somebody's gonna be like starting from zero or feel that way. What's this Nine of Cups? You guys could be dealing with somebody younger than you, or you could be younger than this person, but they're very romantic. They wanna very romantic. They could be a little bit moody, hot and cold, wishy-washy, but they're very romantic and they do have feelings for you. Okay, you may, this, you know, it may feel really familiar with this person. What's this Nine of Cups? They can be very creative as well. The Death card here, Scorpio energy. But I feel like this person has like this Peter Pan syndrome. Yes, you may have given this person excuses because they're younger than you, but I feel like this person is not really going to change. They don't really want to grow up. And that may really suck for you to realize that. This person is, they don't want to grow up. And they also could be holding on to some type of betrayal of an ex, an ex-wife or ex, what's this Death in reverse? That has happened that, you know, that they don't really tell you. What's this, that card in reverse? Yeah, Nine of Cups in reverse. Yeah, I just, yeah. Somebody's really arrogant here. Somebody also overindulges. I also feel like, yeah, some of you guys could have, yeah, somebody here, you guys could have been blinded by the sex. Especially if you guys like were going for rounds and rounds and it was a lot, it was good. Yeah, you know, it could have been a lot of that, but you guys could have been like caught up in how something felt instead of what it was, instead of what is. Okay, don't get so caught up in the chemistry, the sex, that you forget to see what you know, exactly what something is. What's this, true love? Yeah, Ace of Cups. Yeah, Gemini got this energy. So you could be dealing with a Gemini or somebody with this in their chart here. Gemini got this. But you guys are needing to let go of something here. Like somebody here is very restless here. Again, Peter Pan syndrome. Somebody needs to grow up. What's this? You're an Empress and this person is a Knight. That's not, I don't care what age you are. That's not, you're an Empress and this person's a Knight. So there could definitely be an age difference. And somebody could, there could be some finances. And what's this true love here? Yeah, Ace of, ooh, yes, Pisces. We got Ace of Cups, Ace of Wands with the true love. I like that. So you, I'm telling y'all, y'all gonna be having lots of sex, lots of love. It's gonna be intense. Like, it's gonna, some of y'all are, or you guys are with somebody where this is already with it, like, you guys have this already. Somebody could have also had a really difficult and really painful childhood that they kind of disassociate from emotionally. You may notice how they zone out when you guys have certain conversations about certain things, okay? But for some of you guys, this is something new or fairly new, or you haven't, you will be encountering this. And I'm telling y'all, it's gonna be, this is from the, this is from divine. Ace of Cups, Ace of Wands. There's gonna be a renewal here. Or for those of you who are working on your marriage and you're deciding to stick this out, there's gonna be a renewal of love and, you know, chemistry and things like that. Something is definitely a yes. Yeah, oh, heavy Leo energy. You could be dealing with the Leo or Cancer here, or another Pisces. Heavy, or somebody with that in their chart. What's this? Yeah, I'm telling you, you guys, this new, you could definitely be dealing with a Gemini. And you maybe this is somebody from that you met at work or from your past here. This person could have a child already, or you guys may have kids with them, or they have, but somebody could be turned on by somebody being a mother, or seeing somebody being a mother, or the thought of them being a mother here. Okay, but I feel like, yeah, this is definitely heavy. The Lovers here, the Four of Wands, heavy twin flame energy here. Somebody's the yin to your yang here. Yeah, somebody wants to come through. Somebody here, they're taking a while. Heavy Leo energy. They could be taking a while, but they're going to come in. But they have to emotionally abandon something and let something go. Somebody has to let the past go. And they have to, you know, they could be closing out cycles right now and letting go of old things. But something's going to be rebuilt here. Take your time. You don't have to rush. Don't let nobody rush you, especially if they deceived you, lied to you, hurt you, or vice versa. You don't have to rush things, okay? Take your time. The Magician, Gemini, Virgo energy. I mean, y'all could be dealing with a Virgo or a Gem. Heavy Gemini and Virgo here. Libra and Taurus is, yeah. And Leo. Yeah, I said Leo, yeah. Yeah, somebody here is going to send, there's going to be some type of offering of some sort here. Somebody wants to bring you flowers, maybe. Okay, a gift or something. You guys may have your sword up against this person. Like, you guys may need to unblock them. Somebody could be blocked. Somebody could also feel defeated. Somebody could be going through karma for how they treated you. If they took your kindness for weakness. If they mistaken your compassion as you being stupid. Okay. Or naive. Somebody also could be trying to call from blocked numbers, or you guys may, somebody here could be blocked. Somebody's trying to get through to you, but you may have blocked them, or vice versa. What's this ace? I don't even feel like I need to clarify that. That's beautiful. Yeah, some of you guys are some of you guys are manifesting a true love here. You guys are with the person that you guys could be with some of you guys are currently with somebody that you've manifested. Like, you could have manifested this, and you could be looking at this person like, oh shit, I manifested you. Like, wow, I manifested my twin flame or my soulmate, my life partner. Whatever you guys subscribe to and believe in. You guys are like, oh shit. And for others of you, this Empress and Magician energy, whether you're a man or a woman, you're very powerful at this time. So if your focus is love, whatever your thoughts are about love or how people how you show up in love and how people see you, you're manifesting that. So again, when it comes to love, Pisces placement, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, you guys can manifest any experience in love you want. Law of Assumption. Look up the Law of Assumption. Assume you gotta affirmations and Law of Assumption are as if they you gotta assume that it's already yours. The affirmations are how can I describe it? You know affirmations. Look up Law of Assumption. You know, look up Law of Assumption on YouTube. Yeah, some of you guys have manifested this. Some of you guys are manifesting love right now. Some of y'all gonna end up you're gonna end up marrying this person. What's this healing family issues? Yeah, somebody could be needing to let. Yeah, somebody here could. Yeah, somebody holds on to. Somebody emotionally holds on to old traditions. You know, somebody could also be like still in love with like. You got Taurus energy here, all fixed signs: Taurus, Scorpio, Leo, Aquarius. You could be dealing with any of those signs. This is human family issues. Yeah, the Star card, Aquarius. You could be dealing with an Aquarius. So something for those of you who are married and somebody was cheating and they lied and shit like that. I feel like I don't know if this person's gonna change. That's the thing. I don't know if they're gonna change. You know, or they're not. They may say, "Oh, we don't need counseling. Get counseling." Some of you guys. This relationship that you're in or going to be in, yeah, Temperance, Sagittarius energy, is going to be very healing. It's going to help you heal your childhood wounds and things like that. You can heal with this person. Yeah, the Judgment. Yeah, this is, whew. Yeah. Yep, Pisces, this is big. The Judgment here with the healing family issues, you're being called to do this right now. Let me see. You guys are being called to, yeah, this is definitely what's a big factor in your love life right now, Pisces. This is a big factor in your love life is your family issues, whether it's old marriage, an old relationship, or your childhood. This is a big factor for you guys. Spirit is calling on you to heal your and forgive your parents, even the ones that have passed on. Even for the ones that have passed on, you guys are being called to heal that. And also, Spirit is also calling for you guys to, you know, if you know a relationship is toxic and it's abusive, and I'm not talking about y'all. I'm talking about, you know, some infidelity and shit like that. I'm not talking about physical abuse and toxicity, healing family issues. Y'all know what I'm talking about. But some of you guys need to forgive your parents. Yeah, somebody needs to heal. Three of Swords in reverse. Somebody could have a hard time getting. Yo, somebody could be healing. Somebody could be in the process of healing here. Yeah, what's this? Somebody's also not learning lessons here. This could be you, healing family issues. Yeah, Two of Pentacles. So there could be a decision. Somebody here could be weighing the pros and cons. Okay. Somebody could also be wanting to restore something here. Somebody could have did something really foolish. This could have been online, a dating app. Somebody may be deleting that finally. Some of you guys could be in long distance relationships here. Some of you guys could also be moving with this person. What's the Star here? What's the Star? King of Wands in reverse. Yeah, some of you guys need to heal some things around your self-esteem and your image. Pisces energy, the High Priestess. Yeah, you guys are very intuitive though. Yeah, the Empress. I mean, the Emperor. So you guys, this could be your husband, your wife, or your twin flame. For some of you guys, it's a twin flame dynamic. There's going to be some type of reconciliation. Some things are going to heal. This person loves you. And I did see the Queen of Cups and Upright. They're both in Upright. You guys love each other. So I feel like there is going to be restoration and healing here. For those of you who want to stay in this marriage, who want to get back with this person, who want to stay with this person, there is, whether there's an outside child or not, or infidelity or not, whatever the issue or problem was, I feel like you guys want to stay with this person. You guys love each other. You guys are just going to end up blending families. Or you're just gonna, you know, it's gonna, you know, it's gonna take time, but yeah, the Tower, something's gonna be restored here. It could be with a father figure, okay, somebody's father, right? Some of you guys may need to heal your father wounds, forgive your father. If you worry about your father's health, he is gonna be okay. What's this? If they have, he has some heart issues, what's the Three of Swords in reverse? Yeah, the Hermit. Yeah, this could be about a Virgo energy. This could be a father figure. Heavy Virgo, heavy Gemini, heavy Taurus, heavy Leo energy here. Scorpio and Aries as well. And Aquarius. Yeah, some of you guys, somebody here has, somebody could have had an absent father here. Somebody may also need to go see a doctor here as well. Okay, somebody could also be doing some type of self-reflecting and some introspection on past pain and hurts, whether it's through love or family. I'm getting as family, childhood and things like that. Three of Cups. Yeah, somebody's going to be reuniting with a Virgo or with a father figure or some, yeah, a Virgo or a father figure or somebody older. They don't have, yeah. There's going to be reconciliation, a celebration, getting together. Yeah, some of you guys, yeah, you guys are going to be able to restore this. What's this Judgment here? Ten of Wands. Yeah, you guys are being called to work on this, to put in the work, to not give up on this. Yeah, what's this Ten of Wands? Yeah, King of Cups. Yeah, there's love here, you know. Or there's somebody here could be, what's this King of Cups? Let's see. What's this King of Cups? Could be dealing with a Capricorn as well. Yeah, I feel like somebody here may, yeah. Somebody's still deciding, do I want to hold on? Do I want to let go? Do I want to put the work and the effort in, or do I want to move forward? Somebody here is kind of like, they're kind of indecisive. Somebody here is indecisive here. So somebody has a decision to make. Two of Pentacles. Yeah, Two of Wands, Two of Pentacles. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, the Moon card. Yeah, somebody's emotions are kind of up and down. Somebody could be really moody. Somebody could also be having some type of ovarian or endometriosis. Or this could be a child here, or whatever, a teenager, or whatever. Somebody here could be also having really painful periods. Also, somebody needs to balance their hormones. Somebody needs to balance. What's this Moon card? There's a hormonal imbalance here. Also, somebody here has a lot. Somebody's emotions are just all over the place. They're unstable. Yeah, the World card. Yeah, so something could have been hidden. Somebody, yeah, somebody could have been juggling something. Somebody could have find this out online, social media. Okay, Queen of Wands is usually the other woman. This could be somebody that lives across seas. Okay, somebody here could say, oh, I need to, can we take a break for a few months just for them to go? And, oh, I need a trip. I need to go see, and then they go see the, you know, shit like that. What's the look here? But there's a cycle closing out here. Yeah. What's this Ace of Cups? Yeah, ooh, Pisces, y'all got all aces here. Ooh, Pisces, Ace of Cups, Ace of Wands, Ace of Pentacles. I asked what this Ace of Cups and Ace of and Four of Wands was. Ace of Pentacles. A lot of y'all are gonna, ooh, Pisces, woo. It's, woo, woo, woo. Yeah, Pisces. Some of y'all, yeah, y'all, this person's gonna marry you guys. Or there's going to be a new start to this marriage or here. Some of you guys, this person's going to propose to you, or you're going to propose to them. Ace of Wands and Magician. Some of you guys manifested this. You got all aces. Yeah. But somebody here needs to, somebody was blocking. So was blocking your, what can unblock this love or whatever this thing from coming in is, you guys have to emotionally let go of something. You guys have to focus on being happy. If you're not happy with yourself, none of this is going to come in for you. But you got all aces. This is the first reading where I'm seeing all aces here. All aces. All fucking aces, Pisces. All of this. All aces. All aces. All from divine. You guys are going to be blessed And this love is gonna be blessing you guys financially, emotionally, energetically, spiritually, intellectually. Like, you guys are gonna have it all. Or there's a potential. But this is this is like really beautiful, Pisces. A lot of you guys are with your true You guys are with your true love, Pisces. This is a beautiful thing. A lot of you guys are manifesting this, but again, you know, don't give up, because it's here. It's closer than you think. You gotta kiss a few frogs. There could be a fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Kiss a few frogs before you meet your prince or princess. Okay? I feel like this person is showing up confident, sure about who they are, but you gotta match that. You're gonna have to match that. And if it's about, this person could be a trainer, you could be a trainer, okay? Some of you guys could be feeling insecure. This person knows who they are. They're confident in their purpose and you know what they're here to do. Some of you guys need to abandon old beliefs about yourself and leave that old shit behind. Eight of Cups, leave it behind. Abandon it, okay? Leave what's familiar. Some of you guys may be even moving for this person, or they may be moving for you, okay? Just, you know, you won't know until you try. You won't know until you try, okay? So, Pisces, this was your reading. Okay, good luck with everything, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye. Like, comment, and subscribe.